Jesus, God, we pray, God, that you will fill this house. Oh, hallelujah. Fill us, Lord God, on today. Fill us, Lord God, on today. In the name of Jesus, God. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, yes. Fill us, Lord God, on today, God. On today, Lord God.
Lift your worship.
We need your anointing. We need refreshing. We need your glory, oh God.
from the very crown of our head to the very sole of our feet on today, oh God, yet on the ocean, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, deliver on today. Deliver somebody in the mind, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Reclaim backsliders on today, oh God. Those who know you, who once knew you, oh God, but chose to walk away from you on today, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Hey, yet on the ocean. Oh God, move on today, oh God. Oh God, anoint these lips of clay that will speak your word on today, oh God. No flesh being glorified on today. Oh God, we put flesh behind the cross and ask you to have your way. We step forward. You have stepped forward on today, oh God. And God, you move by your power, move by your spirit. Set us a fire afresh, oh God. In the name of Jesus. Burn away everything that's not like you, oh God. High in the ocean. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, we know that the time is winding up fastly, oh God. We know there's a quickening in the spirit, oh God, the spirit realm, oh God. And Satan is working faster than he ever has before, oh God. In the name of Jesus. So God, protect us with your anointing. Protect us by your blood on today, oh God. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah.
Your spirit of your shaman, your shahindios, in the name of Jesus, a fresh anointing, a fresh fire, fresh power from on high, oh God, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Oh God, send forth revival throughout the world, not just America, but throughout this nation's world, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Move by your power. For your glory and your honor and your praise. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. We thank God. We thank God. Amen. Amen.
In Jesus' name, amen. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Oh, hallelujah. God, we thank you, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, God. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, God. I just want to give praise, and we give praise to the Lord God Almighty. Oh, hallelujah, for his presence with us on today. Oh, hallelujah. Because we know that we cannot do anything, not one thing, without our God, without our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, without, oh, hallelujah, the Holy Ghost. Oh, hallelujah. God bless you, woman of God. Oh, hallelujah. We've been going through and like pressing just to be able to get up here today, from the internet to the computer not wanting to come on, from things freezing to the mic not working. But God, oh, hallelujah. But God, oh, hallelujah. Yes, hallelujah. But God, oh, hallelujah. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. There is not one thing, you hear me, not one thing that is too hard for the Lord God Almighty. Oh, hallelujah. God, thank you, Lord God. Each week, each day that goes by, God is doing something more and more and more and more. Oh, hallelujah. And the same way that he's doing it here for us, where he's doing it, oh, hallelujah, for Pastor Davison, for Evangelist Douglas, for Prophetess Janetta, and for myself. He's doing things for you, too. Only thing you have to do, oh, hallelujah, it says reach up, oh, hallelujah. Reach up like this. Reach up and grab God's blessings, to grab what it is that he has for you. It is, we don't supposed to stay in the same place, especially when God is giving us warning, a forewarning about a shift, about that something's going to be released. He has been saying for months, actually since May 2019, he's been given more and more instructions for us to have that one-on-one relationship with him. So I know that God has given the woman of God an awesome word just for the difficulties we've had just trying to get on the line today. And so I know, you know what? I got my listening ears open. You hear me? And so I pray that if there's any spiritual wax, I pray if there's anything that is that in your heart does not like God, or any hurt or pain, that God removes all spiritual wax. He takes away all stones that are at your heart. And that he allows, and that you allow God to come in, for God to come in and stir some things up, for him to remove some things, for deliverance, for healing. And my prayer is that everybody receives the word of God that God has for, I'm not going to say just for me, not just for you, but for the whole world on today. Because this is an international, this is an international prayer line for people from all over, from the east to the west, to the north to the south, from one ocean to another, from high to low, to be able to receive what God has for us. So I pray that you go somewhere and you sit still. Just sit still somewhere. Or even if you're driving, just cut it on where you can hear. If you're, and just find somewhere to be able to receive. And I pray in the name of Jesus that each person that hears is able to receive what God has for them. If it's deliverance, if it's healing, if it is gifting, whatever it is, I pray that they receive it in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 And welcome, welcome. I don't know even if I said welcome, because I'm excited about receiving the word. However, welcome everyone and share it with someone. If anybody desires prayer, come into the prayer room. You can after 5:45, 5:50, or put your prayer request in. Oh yes, y'all gotta see. And what I'll be doing is I'll be paying attention. I'm trying my best to any prayer request that I see that is going up in the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. And let's point, God, use your servant in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank God for being here today. I thank God for this blessing that I have in my hand right here. I thank God for the woman of God that blessed me with it. Amen. To further the ministry. Amen. Because sometimes I'm hard to be heard. But I thank God that God has been providing for this ministry. Amen. We're not in a fabulous studio, but we're in our own dwellings. She's in North Carolina, I'm in Texas. But God sets us up as our own studios. And I thank him for it.
And thank him. Yes, yes.
Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord on my soul. All that's within me. Now, Father God, I put flesh behind the cross and ask you to step forward, use it for your glory and your honor and your praise. God, you know what needs to be said, and you know what don't need to be said. In the name of Jesus, anoint my lips of clay and ask you to use me for your glory and your honor. In the name of Jesus. Take God, anoint the ears of the listeners, oh God, to hear what the Spirit is saying to the churches on today, oh God.
Yes.
In Jesus' mighty name.
In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Yes. Yes.
Amen. On yesterday, I was asking God, say, God, what you got for me to say on tomorrow? He didn't say anything all day yesterday. So early this morning.
Amen.
I was waking. And he gave me a word. Then he getting the next, I went back to sleep, I woke up again, he gave me something else. Then I went for the prayer call, he gave me something else. Amen. So, amen. Get ready for this word of God.
Amen.
It's not of me. It's not of me.
Amen.
But it's all God.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. And the subject is, don't compromise your godly standards. It costs too much.
Amen. Amen.
Your godly standards, it costs too much. Don't compromise your godly standards. Amen. A compromise means to settle dispute by mutual concessions, accept standards that are lower than desirable, to cause to become vulnerable or function less effectively. As I said, as a verb, compromise. as a noun is an understanding. And God says, don't settle for anything that's less effective in your walk with God.
Amen.
God wants you to be effective in your walk with him. Don't compromise with the devil. It costs too much.
That's right. Amen.
It costs too much. First compromising with sin.
Yes.
We can't compromise. Mm-hmm. You're going to lose your life.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Amen. In 1 Kings 11 chapter, verses 1 through 11, it talks about King Solomon has 700 wives and 300 concubines. And God has told him, don't marry these strange women. Don't marry them because they're going to draw you away from me. He did it anyway.
Jesus.
And when he got older, he built temples to Moloch and Chemosh for his idol wives, for his heathen wives. And it drew him away from the Lord Almighty. And God said, since you disobeyed me, I'm going to take your kingdom from you.
Mm.
He said, I'm going to leave you one tribe that will serve me. But the rest, they're going to be given to another. And that was Jehoshaphat. He lost out with God. Why? Because he compromised his godly standard. He knew how to live. He knew how to serve God. He knew how to worship God. But he compromised because he wanted to make treaties with these ungodly kings. And to make a treaty with the king of the ungodly kings, he married their daughter. A man has trouble with one wife. A woman has trouble with one husband. He has 700 wives. And 300
too many.
And it's only 365 days in a year. Think about it. He couldn't satisfy all the women in a year.
My God.
The next year, when he compromised the standards that God has set up for him to follow.
Amen. Amen.
God said, "Don't compromise. Don't marry an ungodly man. Don't marry an ungodly woman.
Teach. Yeah.
No, they're not living right. Leave them alone."
That's right.
If you find them dressing like a hoochie, a scrub, leave them alone. If you're talking ungodly, leave them alone. You can't change them. It only takes God to change somebody. Don't compromise.
Jesus.
It costs you too much.
Jesus, you're right.
You marry ungodly man if you want to. Godly women, they're going to start controlling you. They're gonna start making you change your habits, making you stop going to church.
You're walking heavy now. You're walking heavy.
They're gonna make you stop praying, make you stop fasting. Yes. You know, it don't take you don't take all that.
You're walking heavy.
Yeah. God know your heart is desperately wicked. Above all things, who can know it? Stop dealing with some ungodly men. Stop dating men that look like a thug. All this grill took out and got all them gold teeth, got some diamonds up in front. They look stupid. You're a godly woman. You better wait on God to send you a godly man.
You
giving up your life in Christ Jesus for a piece of flesh.
Break it down.
You can't be that hot and have a man.
Break it down. Yes.
Be that hot and end up in hell.
Mm-hmm. Teach.
That's gonna get wrinkled.
Say so.
Drive you crazy.
Jesus.
Beating you to death when you don't do like they say. Jesus. You weren't doing the will of God, but you gave up to get a man. You gave up to get that ungodly woman, man.
Jesus.
You don't want you to go to church because she is scared that you go fall in love with some other woman in the church.
My God.
I don't want you to pray. You pray too long. You pray too much. Why don't you spend some time with me? Put that Bible up. Let me spend some time with me. You better leave me alone. This Bible keeping us alive. This Bible helps us to live godly before God.
Yes.
Don't compromise your godly standards.
Amen.
It's going to cost you too much.
Mm-hmm.
Don't follow the Joneses. They let their children do anything they want to do. And you got children, you trying to raise them in the fear of the Lord. Don't let them tell you don't take all that to put your children in Sunday school. Y'all let your children stay out late. Y'all let your children go anywhere they want to go. They children, let them do what a child. Let your children pray outside. like we used to. We can go to everybody's house. Because our parents didn't know how our parents were living.
That's right. You walking heavy, woman of God.
Children didn't know how the parents were raising living in their household. They didn't know if the husband was beating his wife. They didn't know if the wife was cheating on her husband. They didn't know if they was drinking and smoking and cursing and listening to them blue records, as we used to call them, Red Fox and all the other ungodly comedians. They didn't know what was going on. So we couldn't go to everybody's house.
No, we couldn't.
Don't compromise your godly standard, because it's gonna cost you too much. Let Billy Ball go over to Schooler's house if you want to, and spend the night and hang out with Schooler if you want to. You're gonna turn out just like Schooler.
Jesus, my God!
In prison or dead somewhere. Don't let Susie run with Maybell. Now Maybell dressing like a prostitute.
Jesus.
12 years old and dressing all those skimpy clothes, and you trying to dress your daughter like a godly. She may not be wearing dresses and stuff. She covering her flesh.
Mm-hmm. That's right. That's right.
Because men and women looking for little girls and little boys.
Oh my God.
Boys and women looking for little girls. It ain't just men looking for little girls and women looking for little boys. No, they switched up on us.
Oh my God. Lord, help us.
It costs too much. Compromising your standards. Solomon lost out with God. In St. Matthew 26, verses 14 through 16, Judas compromised his godly standards. He went to the chief priest to figure out how they was going to betray Jesus, and he lost out. He walked with Jesus 3 years. And he compromised his standards for 30 pieces of silver. And he lost out. He went after he found out what he'd done and he regretted. He lost out. He hung himself.
Mm-hmm. That's right. That's right.
It cost him his life.
His people are compromising
money just to get a name, just to get prestige. It costs you your very soul. People say, I sold my soul to the devil. No, he already had you. You ain't sold your soul. You can't sell nothing that don't belong to you. You gave it up.
Teach.
You're compromising your standards because a young lady come and rub up against you, preacher. You preach a good pastor. Oh, you got some fine muscle. You know, you just dress so nice, and you compromise
your standards. That's right. Yes, ain't you?
To stand by you and pray for you and fast for you. Iron your clothes, so you wash your clothes, cook your food, clean your house, pay your bills, and you lose out with her because you want a chippy.
Jesus. Chicken head. That's what he call them, chicken heads.
You wanna be an apostle, but you got to pay all this money to get all those clothes, and you know God ain't call you to be no apostle. You know God ain't call you to be no bishop. You ain't no evangelist because you don't want a God minister. You don't want to go out and witness. You just want a name so you can earn some money.
Jesus. Lord, help us. Because
somebody say you sound like one. No, you compromising your standards to please somebody else's flesh. God said, no, don't compromise. It's going to cost you your soul doing all this stuff.
Your soul. Oh.
You getting people into the church by having all these gimmicks and stuff. Because somebody say, that's how you get people in. Now preach the word. How you gonna keep them if you don't continue to have these gimmicks and stuff? This preach the word. You're selling your soul. You losing out with God by doing all this stuff that people are suggesting you do.
Jesus.
You compromising your standard, your godly standards. You said, for God I live and for God I die, but you living for the world.
Jesus.
You compromising world standards. People are selling out everywhere.
Amen.
Why? Because they want to please flesh. They want to please the world. They want to please themselves. They want to feed some piece of flesh that's going to dry up after so many years with them.
Yes.
They draw you away, and then they get you, and then they go to somebody else and draw them away too. Why? Because you ain't using discernment and that God gave you to know this is the devil. He's trying to trip you up.
Yes.
The devil's being weak. Does that ever see you being lackadaisical and foolish, compromising? Jesus. It's costing you your very soul.
Jesus, teaching woman of God. This is going to help people. Teach.
Don't you know you got to stand before God for the things that you do in your body?
Yes.
You got to give an account for everything that you say and think and do.
Everything.
It's going to cost you your eternal soul. Because you compromise your godly standards. God's standards are higher than our standards. God is calling for holiness. And holiness means to be set apart, to be sacred, to be separated from that which is unholy, unclean, and unrighteous.
Amen. Amen.
God's calling for holy standards, not ungodly standards, not skanky standards.
That's right.
Boo boo the fool standards. Mm-hmm.
That's right.
He said, "Be holy, for I am holy." He ain't saying you got to be totally perfect, so totally flawless. But he said, "Have godly morals, have godly standards."
Yes.
You can't bring God down to your bar level.
That's
you got to come up to God's level.
God's
standards.
Yes. Yes.
When you come up to the car, if you had certain standards, before you could get on the ride. If you didn't meet that height, you couldn't go on that ride. You have to be in a certain standard to get on a carnival ride.
That's good. That's good.
In Houston, Texas, called Astro World, and we had a certain standard. If a child was not high enough, they couldn't get on that ride.
That's right. That's
if
right.
you're not high enough in the Lord, you can't go to heaven.
You can't get into heaven.
Your standard got to come up.
Yes. Teach.
Your standard got to come. Well, God going to give me. No, time is winding up too fast.
Yes.
I'm taking baby steps. Now, ain't no time for no more baby steps. No. You got to get to getting. Yeah, you just born again, but you got to grow up fast.
Amen.
You got to get this food down, this spiritual food down in you like never before.
Yes.
If you got to shovel it in, you got to shovel it in. If you don't, it's going to cost you your soul, your very soul.
That's right.
It cost Jesus his very life for you.
Teach.
Before he got to the cross.
Teach.
It cost God his only begotten son. It cost God his heart. Jesus was his heart. Jesus came to show us how to love.
Yes. To love.
You're going to compromise your standard, your godly standard for a piece of flesh.
No.
For money,
Jesus,
to get somebody to like you.
Don't do it.
You gotta be concerned if God loves you. Yeah, he do, but he wants you to love him back.
Yes,
it ain't a one way street. No, it don't go just one way. God love me. I don't have to love him back. We show God we love him by the way we live.
Amen.
By how we keep our standards.
Amen.
And too many saints of God have lowered their standards.
Jesus, my God.
To find a place in the world. No. God said, not so. Not so. Can't be. There's only one way the saints are to walk, and that's the way of holiness.
Mm-hmm.
Isaiah 35 and 8 says, it talks about a highway of holiness. Bible also says, so Jesus talks about a broad way that leads to destruction.
You went mute. Woman of God, you went mute. Pastor Davison teaching. She teaching. You teaching, woman of God. You teaching.
There's a way that leads to life eternal.
Amen, yes.
I'm traveling the narrow way. It's only room enough for one to walk that way. I can't take my family in. I can't take a prophet's body in. I got to answer God for myself.
Amen.
And so can't take mama in there with you.
Mm.
You can't take him down the road with you. You got to walk this walk by yourself. The world sure don't go with you.
Yes.
It's going to cost you trying to drag somebody else along, and they don't want to go. You can't drag nobody kicking the street screaming behind you.
Mm.
It's a room enough for just one person to go. Don't compromise your standards.
That's right.
Don't compromise your standard because it's going to cost you too much.
Teach.
You can't enter into the narrow gate with all that baggage. You better get it dropped off.
Amen.
And ask him to cut it off for you.
Amen. Yes.
Some tie around your neck about to choke you to death.
Jesus.
Some tie around your ankles hindering you from walking with the Lord. Some on your arms where you can't raise your arms to praise the Lord. You better get it off.
Mm.
Better get it off because time is winding up. Time is winding up.
Amen. Teach.
It's speeding up.
Teach.
This is the eighth or ninth day of March already.
It's flying by. It's going by quick.
Yes, very quick.
Yes.
The Bible says that unless God shorten the day, no flesh can be saved. He's shortening the days real quick.
Amen.
Volcanoes erupting.
Amen.
So, earthquakes all over the place.
Yes, Lord God.
Snowstorms where it shouldn't be.
18,000 earthquakes in one day in the same place.
In New Zealand.
Jesus, my God.
There's more variants of coronavirus. And you're telling people that you don't have to wear your mask no more.
Jesus, my God.
If you get fully vaccinated, you don't have to wear your mask. You can go anywhere you want. Even if the other person that you're around ain't vaccinated. No, time winds up. Don't compromise.
Yes.
If you know what God told you to do,
do it.
Because it's going to much. It's gonna cost you a whole lot. If God told you don't go down that road at night, and you know where you're not supposed to go, don't go down there because it's gonna cost you too much.
Amen.
Somebody gonna rob you. Somebody gonna kill you. It's gonna cost you too much.
Amen.
It's gonna cost you if you don't lower your standards. Yes. Don't lower your standards for this world, because world loves its own. If you ain't part of the world, they don't love you.
Oh,
matter of fact, the world don't love the world. They're killing too much. They're killing just for on a whim, just because they you got something they want, or just because they want to kill you.
Jesus.
For the color of your skin, for the look in your face, they'll kill you, or they try to. Husband putting hits out on their wives, wives putting hits on their husband.
Jesus.
Parents putting hits on their children. The world has gone stone cold crazy. Don't compromise. And run with the Joneses. The Joneses are just as broke as you are.
Mm-hmm.
Don't compromise. It's going to cost you too much.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Too much? Mm-mm. It ain't worth it. What does it profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his soul?
Teach.
What would a man give in exchange for a soul? You can't give nothing in exchange for your soul because it don't belong to you. God said all souls belong to him.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to cost you too much. You're going to lose out. You're going to find yourself sitting in hell waiting on judgment. In torment, screaming. Saying, I wish I had another chance. You gave up your chance when you died without Jesus.
Mm.
You gave up your chance when you backslid and you died without Jesus. It costs you your very soul. So today God said, don't compromise your godly standards. Don't compromise your standards. Come to Jesus. If you don't know him, come to him.
Amen. Yes.
Get to know him. And he'll give you, he'll show you the way that you're supposed to walk. Don't walk the way of the world, because the world don't know which way it's want to go. The world tell you to do one thing one day and another thing the next day. Don't follow the world. Don't follow the world, because they don't know which way they're going. Follow Jesus. Take no chance of getting lost. Follow Jesus.
Amen.
Follow him all. Hallelujah. Follow the Lord all the way. Follow Jesus.
Yes.
Take no chance of getting lost.
Mm-hmm.
Don't take no chances. It's going to cost you too much. It's going to cost you your very, very soul.
Mm-hmm.
In Jesus' name.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. Oh, that's a man. Oh, that's a man. Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. I thank the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. 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 Oh, hallelujah. Woman of God. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Such an anointed word. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, a real word. Do you hear me? That is a real word for the people of God. It is a real word for those that are concerned about a relationship, a boyfriend, a girlfriend, or getting married, and everything else but the Lord God. And what a word is, don't compromise your godly standards. It costs too much. You broke it down. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, God. Oh, hallelujah. God, oh, I got to see you broke it down. And the only thing, Hordesh, I got to see that I can say at this point is that so many people, they'll see somebody or man or woman and they'll hook up with them knowing that God says, no, not so. Thinking, oh, I'll change them. Oh, I'll change them. Or I can get them to go do this. Or I'll get them to go do that. And because you're going into the relationship thinking you're going to change somebody. Oh, my God. It's not going to work. And two, that if they change, it's going to be temporal. It's not going to be permanently because they're changing for you. And not for God. But when God comes in and changes somebody, oh, hallelujah. Now that's a true change, right, woman of God? Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. And I bless the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Gosh, I got to see a good word, woman of God, a good word. God is saying that on that word, that is the word to bring many to Christ. Many that have lost their way. A lot of Christians that's going around with the bebop dudes, with their pants sagging off their butts. The big gold chains. Yeah. And then when people look at them, they say, is that your boyfriend? And they know automatically that you're in flesh not listening to the Lord God. And that you don't, instead of you going higher and higher, that you just don't went this way and that way. I mean, everywhere but the Lord God.
Yeah.
And so, gosh, I got to see, God is saying for you to go even to go forth and lead these people unto Christ, woman of God, because they have lost their way. He brought this word as a word of conviction. That their souls will be convicted. So as you pray for these individuals, I'm going to intercede. If any has a prayer request at this time, I pray that you go and you put the prayer request in the comment section, or you can even go into the Zoom room. God is saying also that many are interceding for a friend, their sister, or their brother in Christ. Their grandchildren, their great-grandchildren, their niece or nephew, because they see them going astray. And God is saying, woman of God, he's placed a more of an anointing on you. And for you to go forth. So at this time, I'm turning it back over to you right now while you made this call for Christian discipleship, and that those that have been bound, that they can be unbound at this time. In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord.
Thank you.
For those who are praying for the great-grandchildren, the nieces and nephews, God says, look at your lifestyle first. Look at how you live it. Was you praying for them going astray? Was it following you? You believe that you live in God. But God says, look at your life before you pray. And then when you change, if you find something wrong in your lifestyle, change it. And they will hear you. They will listen to your word. Right now, they're not listening. They're going wrong. And God says, no, it's time for you to change. Father God, I come before you, just ask you to touch the hearts of the people that are listening. Touch their hearts, God. to come to you in the name of Jesus. I can lead them to you. I can pray for them. I can pray with them. But such their hearts to want to come to you in the name of Jesus. If you don't know Jesus in the free pardon of your sins, now is the time to come to him. Of your sins. Ask God to wash you of all sin. All unrighteousness. In the name of Jesus. Father God, I come before you as a sinner. As you wash me with your precious blood. I acknowledge you. I acknowledge my sin, my transgression before you.
Yes, God. You went on mute. Yes. Cool. You're unmuted now. Yes. We can't hear you, woman of God.
I know I'm a wrong woman, oh God. In the name of Jesus. That you want to give up to me. I believe this woman. He walked to earth for years. He's not broken in the bed. He's not going to be a child of the Lord. I want to receive your vision. In the name of Jesus. Wash me and make me whole, oh God. In the name of Jesus. By the power of my life. Bless you, God, to be your child. Wash, write my name in the Lamb's Book of Life. In the name of Jesus. Move by your power and your spirit in my life, oh God. In the name of Jesus. God, you're a backslider. And that you'll have your way in my life, oh God. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, just have your way with me. I repent of my sins. Actually, restore me back into your kingdom, oh God. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, reclaim me. Wash me over again from the very crown of my head to the very sole of my feet, oh God. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, I need you. Things are in turmoil in my life, and I need you to reclaim me. I actually need you to wash me over again. Make me over again, oh God, in the name of Jesus. And I thank you, oh God, for receiving me back home in the name of Jesus. Lord God, I'm not a backslider, I'm not a sinner, but God, I need more fire in my life. I need more substance in my life. I've compromised my standards somewhat, oh God, and I should renew me again, oh God. In the name, I commit my life back unto you, oh God. In the name of Jesus. I've been stumbling along. I've been complexing, oh God. And actually set me aside afraid, oh God. In the name of Jesus. Use me for your glory and your honor, oh God. Hallelujah. Give me a mind to increase my prayer life, my fasting life, my spending time with you, oh God. Increase it, oh God. Give me a mind to fellowship with you more and more and more and more in these very last evil days, because you're soon to return. And I thank you for it right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, I bless you, God. I give you glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Jesus' name.
Oh,
head, yeah, God is saying, don't go back either. Oh, yeah, he says, you need help. Oh, yes, you need help. He's there. And just ask. Many of you are held down by the spirit of loneliness. And God is saying, the ones that you're delivered from that spirit of loneliness, then, oh, hallelujah, that he can make you over again. He says, you gotta let flesh go. You have to let all of the things which you have to see, that is not of the world, that the woman of God, or she gotta see. Preach, Hana Manasaye, Heavy Shaye, Tarada Sea. He says, says that this is a word, Lord, Shabbatasi, to break chains, or Shabbatasi, and to send it to those that you know that are having a difficult time, or you know that they're in those relationships that are not of Him. And God says, woman of God, or Shabbatasi, Pastor Davison, that He is well pleased. He says you laid it out simple. That no one can say that they didn't understand it. He says sometimes people just go too, and people can't receive because it just goes past their head. However, going out and trying to get those lost sheep, He came. You came just the way that God told you to come. And you're well pleased. Come. And this weekend that God, He told me not to do the Trinity prayer line because He to rest, but during that time period, I didn't really rest. He was pouring into me, and He was pouring into me the things that He desired me to do with you. Stand back up, woman of God. Stand back up. Hold us, and He said, that you mentioned the mic that I sent you. He told me why He placed it on my heart to send. And He said, that is for your new walk. Help me, Holy Spirit. God is saying, that the mic, just like as Moses, he had the staff. And that his staff, He told him what, and He instructed him to do with it. And as a shepherd, He says, people are gonna come. And even as you are up here, as the shepherd, He says He's with you. But this, you're the might that He had me to send. He says He's blessed. And He has. I'm going for the work. And He shall be with you. God says, that yes, that He said that there was going to be a release on this month. One of the releases, has been upon this ministry that He has us doing, He's equipping us for the work, and the walk, that we're walking in. He says, did you know, as I do, that we are, and who we are in the Lord God, an apostle. And He's given me specific instructions on what we are to do and what you, as His apostle, right now, but because of where He's going with you, and where He's taking you. Is equipped in even more. So hold your hands into the air and put the mic up there with you. In your hand. Keep it in your hand. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, You told me, Lord God, on what to do. You told me, Lord God, what the mic is for. And Lord God, where you're taking this woman of God, and the people that you've told me, God, to have come up here, to do your work, your will, and Lord God, as the woman, your apostle stands before you, she is prepared, God, for the equipping, to be even more prepared, God, for the work, for the release. So, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, woman of God, say yes to the Lord, God, yes to the new walk, yes to the new talk. I see snakes, so she gotta see scorpions on the ground, that she gotta see. I'm on a game, and as you're walking, that she gotta see, it's like you're not even touching them, or they can't even bite you, that she gotta see, and you're just walking like you saw Jesus, or you imagine Jesus walking on the water. God is saying that there have been people that's even praying against you. But you're covered. And as you're walking, because I can see you just walking, and as you're walking over the snakes, you're walking over the scorpions, all the bugs, it's like all different kind of just bugs and spiders I see too. But then it's like you're on a on an invisible escalator. And God is saying that as each prayer, each non-well wish, each dart that is thrown at you, on that escalator, is that I see you going up like this, higher, and higher. For you to walk in boldness, because he's telling me, and he told me on Saturday, he says the anointing that he has on you is way higher than the anointing that he has on my life. And then I'm walking in, not someone, But he says, that he desires you, to have a boldness, to walk in it, He says that he sees and he hears, but yet, that you're kind of like this, and like, just walking kind of like slow and like and doubting yourself that you're hearing the Lord God. God is saying that you hear him, and he has called you for mighty things. And as you see me walk in the boldness, he's saying that he is charging you to walk with that boldness from this day forth. Because it is within you. He has been equipped you with these gifts. And that some are walking dormant, and on the other ones you second guess. But he says, I see you, like this. And those chains, like you're standing here and your arms kind of like going up in the air. And those chains, that you put on yourself, or thinking that you aren't worthy, that you can't do this, or even putting me like, oh, she has all these gifts, she has this, or she's anointed. God is saying, or she got to see that the anointing that he's placed on you, he's equipped you even more so. As his pastor, because there's souls is out there, and so he had to put an extra anointing on you to guide them, to keep them, to hear them, when they need the Lord God. So you will know how to pray and to guide them. So woman of God, receive the boldness. He says, all that you have went through, all the hurt, all the pain, the way that people did you and treated you, he says it's been for his glory. Even when you saw others being blessed, you sat back and you didn't say anything. You didn't let it bother you. You praise God for their blessing. God says, with that type of humility and that humbleness, is reasons why he chose you. He says, walk boldly. Without fear. Doubting. Am I hearing right? He says, you're hearing. And to go forth from this day forth with such boldness. I don't have to say, Lord God, Lord, cover your eyes, ears, anything, because it's already there in you. So I pray, Lord God, that she walks in that newness, as your apostle, and may her mind be anointed for the world. A woman of God, that's why when you said the mic's not working. It's not working, and so I'm not going to use it. And I said, oh, it's working, because I knew what God had already told me about what the mic meant and what I was supposed to do. And so that's why you didn't see me fret at all. I'm like, well, it's something that you got to go do. Plug it here, plug it there. Because that's why I'm saying the boldness. I had to know that I heard God right. And so, and after you plugged it in a couple places, it worked. And it's like, I knew it had to, because what God said that it meant and what I was supposed to do. But I have went through so much today. I'm like, Lord God, do I have the strength? Do I have it in me to do these things? Because I've been going through. But God says, he let me know, yes. He is well pleased. And he's given me more instructions, not just for you, but for Deanna, Evangelist Deanna, and Prophetess Janetta, and myself. That part of that release and what and how we're to go forth. However, this is one of the last steps. Before we go forth, is what God is blessing us to do. And so the word of God that the women preach, don't compromise your godly standards. It costs too much. It does. It does. It can cost your eternal soul. It can cost what God desires for you to do. Because the woman of God was obedient when she brought this word to you. Because many of you have been called, chosen, by God for his word. But you're getting so caught up in flesh on what you want, this man, this woman, and being disobedient to God. And like the woman of God says, the apostle, she says, the word of God says, be ye holy, for I am holy. God wants us to be holy and chaste because he can't bless mess. And so many of you are holding up your own blessings. You're holding up your own giftings. Because like last week, he had the woman of God, which I got to see, apostle, which I got to see, to teach about impartation. And he was telling me the same thing. Like when I was in the restroom getting ready, I says, well, why didn't you tell me I was supposed to teach? Because he was talking to both of us and giving me confirmation on what we're supposed to do. And so that on tomorrow, I'm supposed to be going forth in part two. Again, the woman of God came again, teaching the word to get you prepared. And so don't miss out. And so I encourage each person on today that if you didn't give your life to Christ a while ago, when Apostle Davison gave that altar call or that call for Christian discipleship, that you do so. Because otherwise, you delay what God has for you. As she said, we don't know the time or the date when Jesus is going to come back. Don't miss it. At this time, I'm turning everything over to you, to Pastor Davison. And I pray, God, in the name of Jesus, God, that I've said and did everything that you desire me to do. I pray, Lord God, that the gifts, and the boldness, Lord God, that your apostle, your pastor, she walks in it boldly, God, from this day forth, from even forevermore. And Lord God, as you was with Moses, you even said, so am I with her, and what the might, God, that you had me to send to her, that she uses it, as you direct her to, God, in the name of Jesus. And I pray that everyone that is listening and will listen, God, that they receive that word into their hearts and minds and go forth in your name, God, in Jesus' name, amen. Lord, amen. Thank you, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah! Hallelujah, hallelujah, God. Lord, yes, Shamanasi, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, God, yes, Shamanasi, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord, use her, God. Oh, yes. Your will, your glory, Lord God. And then, oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, God. Thank you, Lord God. And replace all virtue, God, that has been held out, God, and in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Woo! Knew God was up to something today.
Awesome.
God was up to something today. Yeah. That was fighting too hard on today.
Yes. Yeah. That's why we were going through all what we were going through.
Yeah.
I don't have to take out the new now.
Devil, you are defeated. I'm going to sit down. I can't take it.
Yes, he did. Yes, he did. That's why we went through as much as we have went through today.
Yeah.
I got to say, because of what God had planned. Oh, yeah, I got to see for his people. Yes. Thank you.
And he knew what he was doing. He ain't let us know nothing. We were pomp and circumstance. No, God said, no, I'm gonna mess up my program.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, God. Hallelujah.
That's why I had a dream this morning. Amen. How God, I was going through some stuff and God was taking me some places and I had to go through some stuff. And I ended up in a place, I never thought I'd be. And guess what? I'm in a place I never thought I'd be. And as you were talking, that robot order that I got for less than what it should be, that's why God blessed me to be able to get that robe.
Amen.
And I checked on the status of it, and it looks like it's gonna get here quicker than what they say.
Jesus. I you know what? It's probably gonna be here on the date that God gave. Cordius, I gotta see for the on the next part of the things that he's guiding me and what we're supposed to do. Yes. Oh, hallelujah. Thank God. He's awesome. Yes, he is.
That's the second time he's been blindsided me. he blindsided me on Friday. He blindsided me today.
Oh my God.
Thank you, God.
Yes,
Lord. And God gave you exactly what was going on in my spirit. Because I was thinking, Prophetess Bonnie, I'm there, but I'm not where she is. And God said, no, you didn't surpass the daughter. You didn't supersede her. No. I accept it.
Thank you, God. Yes, he talked about the anointing that's on your life. Amen. And sometimes it's us that hold ourselves back because we think that we are unworthy and that we're hearing God wrong or he's not saying this or saying that. It's us, we hold ourselves back, but he wanted you to know, you have this anointing on you, woman of God, call for purpose, and for you to start walking in it. I look at it, that's why he didn't have me having you to do this and this or whatnot, because you're already there and pass me on that. So I thank you, Lord God. I thank you, God.
I'm like Moses. Like Moses said, who am I? Because God said, talk to Pharaoh. God said, I'm a man of stuttering lips. No. He said, well, take your homeboy with you. Take Aaron with you. Since you feel like you can't talk. But all Adam was a mouthpiece. He used Moses to perform the miracles and the signs and wonders. He used Moses. He eventually used Moses to speak a thing into existence.
Amen. Yes. And that's why he had you and I both standing up. Mike is muted. Standing up as we interceded for the prophetess because of where God even said he's taking her. I thank you, Lord God. I thank you, God. Oh, he's just amazing. Our God is amazing. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. And I just bless the Lord God.
And what you said also was true. I would rejoice when other people were getting blessed, when other people were getting elevated. I was rejoicing with them. Okay, I was pushing them on.
That's just why the fight and the press was so hard and difficult today. That's trying to get on the line and me being totally exhausted. And I just thank God for the strength that he gave me. because the enemy wanted me not strong, so I couldn't do what God was asking to do. But you know what? As always, he's defeated in the name of Jesus. Yes. Amen.
Like I was saying before, I got muted again. I'm going tomorrow, definitely tomorrow, and check on my phone. I just thank God for just blessing me to be able to get pushed, for him pushing me up. Because I just go with the flow.
Yes.
I'm looking for God to push me nowhere. I'm not looking God for to push me up. Whatever he got me to do on this level, I'll do it. As long as he wants me to do it. What he wants me to do it. And that's why he's pushing me up. It's not nothing of myself, but it's all God. It's not me. It's all God.
Amen.
I give him all the glory. I give him all the praise.
Amen. Thank you.
Who would have thought I'd be on an international platform? I'd be part of an international platform.
Amen. I'm like that too. I'm like, Lord, it's all God. Because we never know what direction he's going to take us in. But Lord, only thing we have to do is always submit to him. Submit to the leading of the Holy Spirit. Let go and let God. And that's what's so important. And that's what's going to be needed in today. And also wisdom and discernment. Because just as you said, with every day they're coming back. And the thing about it, you and I talked about the contradiction of what the people were saying. And so that's why it's so important that we use discernment and wisdom when it comes, and obedience to God as far as what we do and don't do.
Not compromising our godly standards, because I come before. No, Jesus paid it all. I'm going with that price. Ain't a discount. Amen.
Yes. I didn't see any additional prayer requests there. At this time, I'm yielding it to you for us to go forth. Yes.
Now unto him who is able to keep you from falling, to the only wise God, be dominion and power, both majesty, both now and glory. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Walk in it, woman of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Amen.